Today I'll show you how to use the RF EasyLink transmit and receive examples. We'll start by importing the examples in Code Composer Studio to our project. In order to do so, open the TI Resource Explorer, scroll down to the RF examples, click on RF EasyLink RX, click on import. That will import your project into Code Composer Studio. Then, in order to build the example, click on this build button. First time you build, it will take some time. After it's done, click on this little debug button. In order to download the code, switch on the board, click on debug. This will download the code to your board. In order to start running the code, click on this button or F8. When I click on that, we see that LED2 is blinking. This indicates that the project is running. Okay, now we have a receiving end of this demo. We'll switch off the board in order to build the transmitting end of the board of the example. So import the EasyLink TX project into Code Composer by following the same procedure as for the RX. So go to TX, click on import, that will import the project into Code Composer Studio. Build and download in the exact same way as you did for the RX part. Make sure your TX board is powered on. Click on debug in order to download the code to your board. Click on the play button to start the actual program. On the TX board, we see LED1 blink every time a packet is being transmitted and LED2 blink for every 10th packets. So now let's switch on the RX side as well. We see that the LED1 is blinking every time we receive a packet and LED2 blink every 10th time. So now we are transmitting data from this transmission board to this receiving board. This example was using the EasyLink API. The EasyLink API should be used in application code and is intended to abstract the RF driver in order to give a simple API for customers to use as is or extend to fit their application use case. For more information about the EasyLink API, please visit ti.com. Thanks.